again, everyone. Todd Starucci, the horror nerd, here at Scares That Care Charity Weekend number 7 in Williamsburg, Virginia. We are winding down day one Friday here at the convention. It's been a blast for me personally so far, and that trend continues right now because I have the pleasure of standing here next to Alex Kintner from Jaws himself, Mr. Jeffrey Voorhees. Jeff, how are you?
I am fine, thank you. I'm pretty good for being dead for 46 years.
Right? That was a hell of a childhood.
Yes. No, they filmed it up on Martha's Vineyard, Amity Island, and I had just moved down to Martha's Vineyard that year, and they're making a movie. They need a lot of extras, and we all signed up to be in the movie. They're going to give you $40 a day, and so they called a few people back. Read this. It's like, okay, you get 140 a day. You get a speaking part. But so that's how it all started. I just moved down the island, and I'm still there now on Amity Island.
Ah, cool.
I run my dogs down on the beach where I was eating every day, doing cameos down there. It's like, but filming it was fun because they were making the movie. It was one of Spielberg's first movies, and so everything had to be perfect. And if you know New England at all, up in Cape Cod, Martha's Vineyard, you don't want to go swimming there until like August.
Right. It's cold. Water's cold.
And they did it in May, and the deal was they had to be out of there before the busy summer got there. Mm. So people are like, were you afraid of the shark? No, I was afraid of freezing my 12-year-old butt off. It's like, so, but filming it, you know, the first, Spielberg would be going, okay, now beg your mother, her name was Lee Fierro, she was really sweet, beg her to go in the water, and Brody, he's right there on the beach watching, and everyone on that beach, you knew him, they were all from the island. Like Brody's the oldest son, I was good friends with him, and the little mellow kid, he lives up in Vermont now, I see him, he comes down to the island once in a while. But filming that, that's where Spielberg, this is back before they had a lot of rules and regulations, so they got away with some pretty rough stuff with kids.
I was really?
But Spielberg goes, beg to go in the water, and then so, you know, telling Lee Farrell, can I go back in? And she's like, no, your fingers are prone. And unfortunately, she let me go back in because that's where you start hearing, dunna, dunna. Mm. Bam, the blood's flying. But Spielberg goes, after you go in the water, starts swimming out, and it's about 20 yards out, there's a machine, a barrel full of blood. It's like right on the top of the water, you really couldn't see it. And then he goes, as soon as you get near this, we'll say cut. So you paddle out in the cold water, and then all of a sudden, you get off the raft, and they put a half a raft over this barrel full of blood. And he goes, you're gonna lie on top of it now. So you're not even on the raft when they're doing that part. You're lying on a machine full of blood with half a raft. And then Spielberg's like, now lie on top of it. And when it explodes, go in the water and stay under there as long as you can. So 12 years old, freezing your ass off, and this thing's gonna explode. It's like, for the first time, bam, blood starts flying up in the air. I hold my breath, go in the water. It's like, finally I swim ashore. It's like, we all set, and Spielberg's like, no, your arm came out of the water. We got to do it again. It would take 7 or 8 hours for all that blood to clear out.
Sure.
And then you try it again the next time, you know, since I had a joint SAG, Screen Actors Guild, I went to a nice warm dressing room every time I messed up. My friends are all freezing cold out there because of my mess up. It's like, the second time, though, your leg came out, and 5 days later, he finally goes, this time we got two guys in wetsuits. They're going to lift you in and out of the water a few times and pull you under and give you air. That's why, like in the scene where you see me going up and down.
Oh, sure. Yeah, we'll get a shot of that.
You see him going up and down, and it's like, how'd you get lifted up? Each guy in a wetsuit have one leg, and they lift you up and down, and they pull you under and give you air.
Wow.
So we finally got it after 5 days, but filming it was fun. Like, there's a little parade in the movie, and I had just moved to the island. I was in that band, and Spielberg wasn't going to let me be in that because the band was in it. And he goes, well, no, you're not dead yet, so you could be in that. So that scene with some little kid with long hair. Now there's no hair, but little kid with long hair.
Really?
Banging on the drums. It's like, I was in that part, too. So a lot of little things are fun. And they would have, like, cookouts, baseball games, Richard Dreyfuss. Those guys would be out there playing. And you look over, there's Robert Shaw, and you run over to him. and you can smell the booze on him.
Oh, it's like, please.
You run up, hey, how's it going? And he's like, ah, get away from me, you little shit. Like, and he sounded just like in the movie. And it's a small island, so basically, anytime you saw him, you just run up to piss him off.
Nice.
Like, nice. Little things like that, or like the shark's name was Bruce.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a small island, so this little yacht club let them use their warehouse to store the shark in. And back then, you didn't have cameras and alarms. So, like, at nighttime, go down with a flashlight, open the window up, and climb all over the shark. And down at a sign-in in Florida a couple of years ago, Field & Stream, the magazine, had, they go, we want two people that were eaten by a shark to be doing the signing at the shark tournament.
Mm.
So they got Susan, the one that dies before.
Sure, yeah.
She was down at that. And then the person that made the shark, he was there. So down there, they have, you get up on stage and people ask questions. And they were talking to him first. And they're like, so we hear you have problems with the shark. And it broke down a lot.
Mm.
And the salt water and stuff. And when I got the microphone, it's like, okay, I got to be honest. And I go, I was only 12 years old when they were filming that movie. But the reason the shark broke down, we might have a little something to do with it. We used to climb in the window and climb all over it all the time at nighttime. Maybe that's why it broke down. And
wow.
He looked like he wanted to kill me. Like, you know, what did he do? Like little things like that. It was fun. And,
oh, that's great.
Yeah, they filmed Jaws 2 down there. Then we all signed up again. They get to me. They're like, you can't be in this movie. It's like, why not? You died in the first one. It's like, I go, well, I'm older. I look different. They're like, well, if the media ever found out, you ruined the movie. It's like, oh, walk away. So, you know, fun little things. So, you know, cookouts, break it and climb all over the shark. Or, you know, that when they say the don't cut it open. They drove that thing all the way up from Florida.
Oh, wow.
And that thing stung so bad. Like the school that they filmed it, it's just up the street. So you can smell that rotting shark for days. And people on the island weren't happy with that whole thing. And where Spielberg was saying, people go up in there and throw dead fish carcasses up on the lawn that he was saying that just because the shark smells so bad. They're throwing stinky fish on his yard.
Wow. Well, you heard it here, folks. The reason Bruce the Shark broke down so much is because these kids were climbing all over it in the middle of the night. Who would have thunk it?
Well, the damn thing ate me. I'm going to climb all over it and rip them apart.
Jeffrey, does it ever surprise you that, so obviously it's an iconic scene. It still gives me nightmares. But what was essentially a kind of a small part, but in the original blockbuster, does it surprise you the longevity that after all this time, people are coming to meet you because you got eaten by a giant shark?
It's gotten more and more. The Jaws, there's like Jaws clubs, and like I do, I live on the island and still, like, I run my dogs on the beach where I got eaten. And like, came down yesterday and I had two cameos to do. It's like, I run my dogs on, it's like, hey, happy 50th birthday from the dead Alex Kintner here on Amity Island. Have a Jawsome birthday. And they're like, oh, it's like, you get all those, or like this one Amity Jaws Club, it's called. They pay a certain amount to cameo and you do an interview. And they were so happy they got over 10,000 people in their club now. So for one hour, and a lot of them are in Europe. So they just ask you questions. So you got a lot of Jaws fanatics out there now. And like this one girl at one of the signings in New York, can you sign right under the collarbone? It's like, yeah, it's just going to come off in a couple days. No, I'm meeting up with Peter later. He's going to tattoo over it. It's like, I'm a 12-year-old kid. It's like,
horror fans are interesting.
But if it's on TV, you still get a royalty check.
Sure.
And the top part you rip off, and the bottom part will tell all the details. It'll say Universal Studios, episode Jaws, your name, taxes, union dues, and you just throw that part away.
Mm.
And a couple of years ago, these people from England came into the wharf, the restaurant that we have, and they had something in a picture frame they wanted signed. And I thought it was a picture of me dying. And I go over and I look at it, it's like Universal Studios, episode Jaws, my name, the amount of the check, 1981, CBS, and union dues, something I had thrown away. It's like, where the hell did you get this? And they're like,
wow.
oh, eBay on an auction. I go, how much did you pay for something I threw away back in 1981? Oh, we got it for $8,700. It's like, oh my God. It's like,
wow.
Yeah, so wow. There are jars for that out there.
There are. Well, Jeffrey, thank you so much for a few minutes of your time. I truly appreciate it. It's great to see you down here at Scares the Care
for
a good cause.
I kind of like helping out this because, you know, this helps out people with cancer and stuff. And I got by that. So it's, you get good, by all that.
Good for you.
Cancer, shark attacks, you get by all of it.
But right. Well, look, if you can survive Jaws, you can survive anything.
I go along with that. Yes.
Fantastic. Jeffrey Voorhees, everybody down here at Scares the Care Charity Weekend in Williamsburg, Virginia. I am Todd Struch, the Horror Nerd, signing off. We will see all of you in the next interview.
Have a jawsome day.